Howdy tubers, got a new repair. This is the Sony MHC-ZX30AV receiver mini system. There's a few issues with it. First, we have to fix the display. It's dim and it's a little erratic. We'll have to put a knob on it. Didn't come with that. It's got a nice ding in the top, as you can see there. I know they when I test it, the CD player it does not pop out, so we'll see what's up with that. Maybe a repair video for that. We'll test all the tape decks, and looks like it could be vacuumed out. It's a little dirty. Not too bad. But, I will say one thing. This receiver is very heavy. So let's pop it open and see what it looks like on the inside. Yikes. That would explain why it was so heavy. I mean, they literally have managed to wedge an AV receiver into this mini system. I mean, look at the size of that transformer. That thing is huge. Here's your rectifiers. Your main filter caps there. For the amps. A little bit of dust in there. Not too bad. If you notice the amplifiers, that's the surround. I think it says right on it, surround amp. It's a two channel by the looks of it. Well, we got the inputs there. Then we looks like two. Oh wait, no, there's I think it's a six channel. Anyway, you can see the IC being used. Looks like an SDK, but I can't make out what it is. And then underneath there's another one, which we'll get the model number off of it. It's wedged in there. There's your tape deck. The belts still look good. Well, no, they feel, they're like mush. That'll never work. Okay, the belts are gone on that. I can tell you that right now, but it'd be easy to replace. Don't even need a tool to remove that one. But one thing at a time. Let's get the figure out how to get the CD player out of it. It's gonna take some work because I think it goes right to here, from there to there, and it just slides out once you take all the screws out. But we'll have to pretty much disassemble a lot of the unit just to get at it. So I'll have to see what I gotta do. We had this plate here. It says has high voltage logo on it. And that is your pickup for your CD player. Just sitting in there. I don't know how the hell you're supposed to service it like that. Interesting. Why they would make it like that. You can't pop it out. Well, I guess you could. You take all the screws out and you can undo the ribbon cable there. And then you can pop it out and clean it. But the cleaning is not the issue we have. The issue we have is it doesn't want to come out. So it's likely a belt. But we'll have to figure out how to get this out. We're going to have to take, I guarantee we're going to have to take the front right off. Unplug all the cables. Well, let's keep digging. Okay, to get the front off, you're going to unplug all your ribbon cables. And I do mean all of them. On the board here. See, this one only reaches, well, it doesn't reach there, so you don't have to worry about making a mistake. You can mark them before you take them off, but that one goes there. It's the longest one that goes to the bottom. You got this one that goes to the power supply, or the transformer. That's probably your power good, or the display. This one here, I think, is for your power good there. Oh, that's for the headphone jack, goes to the amp. And then you got to remove this strap right here. It's a ground strap, and then you should be able to lift the whole front right off. I'll try it. Yep, just doing that will make it much easier to service your deck. So, like this one needs new belts, and I only see one motor here. So I'm trying to figure out how the other... Something's not right here. That's weird. There should be two belts going to each deck. this motor here is only driving this side. Oh, look at the belts. They're totally gone. Oh yeah, they're like glue. So we know the tape deck won't work. Not without a kit. Okay, well, I'm not going to use that right away anyway. Well, we're going to get this out. Hopefully it's not full of junk or full of CDs. We'll probably end up unplugging this one. Unplugging this one. As for the controls and the motor for the to open and close the door. Oh, here we go. This is probably the belt in question right here. Bet you I can keep turning this, I could probably open it up. And you can see that belt is wonky wonky. Alright. Sure, I wish I could change that belt out without taking it apart. Oh well. Let's keep going. Okay, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. As you can see, it's pretty dusty. So that's going to impair how well it functions, this CD player. You get a lot of belts here. There's at least 3 belts that I could see that need to be replaced. They're all spongy. You're going to need to take this screw out, all the ones on the back bottom, and all the ones on this side by the transformer. And then you should just be able to just lift the base or the bottom right off, and it'll give you a slab like that. There's some stuff floating around there. Ooh, there's some dirt. Okay, well, I'm going to see what I can do about belts. See these belts here, I'm not even going to special order them. I'm just going to use freaking hair belt, elastics. Kids hair elastics would work pretty good for this. Not even gonna bother, but we'll see. We'll make sure it's the belts. Well, I couldn't find any belts laying around, but I did find this. These are the elastics that come when you buy onions. So we're gonna try those, see if they'll actually fit. Well, too bad I couldn't do that with the tape deck too, but those are flat cables, so that's not gonna work. But there you go. All that's left to do is I'm gonna throw the thing back on it, this clamp, and excuse me, dust. We'll throw it back together, plug it in, and see if it actually works. As you can see, the display has still got some issues. I haven't got to that yet, but we're gonna see if we can get the CD player to eject. CD. Oh, I think I turned it off. Oh, this makes sound. Is there something I forgot to plug in? I think I did. Yeah, always double check to make sure everything is plugged in. Hopefully I didn't damage it. Sounds alright. Nope, I don't think those belts will work. Oh! It's going through the trays. I think it might do it. What I want to do is I want to eject it. That was the issue. The tray wouldn't come out. When I hit the trays, oh, here we go. Well, it's going through the discs. It's just, that's probably just me. I can't get it to eject. So I'm working on it now. Let's see if I can get it to eject also. Oh, ejected just fine. That's all it was the belts. Eject four. Just have to push it once. Let's drop a disc in and see if it'll play. Well, here goes nothing. Which one was that for? I don't remember. I hear it reading. Yep, it works. It's playing. Cool. No problem with it now. So those little elastic bands do will get you up and running, but I can't imagine they'll last too long. So what I'll do before I put it back together is we'll go over the display, how to brighten it up a bit, because I can tell you there's some dust and dirt in there, and I might remove the plastic cover that's in there that makes it white. It'll be green, but it'll be darker or lighter. You'll be able to see it better. And we'll take the belts off for the tape deck, because I'll take all the belts in and get new ones for it. That is a massive display. You can see how it's sealed on the end there like a tube. It's massive. And you can see that's what they put in front to change the lettering from blue to white. And you can see it does get a little film on it. Rub your finger on it. I don't think cleaning it's really going to brighten it up that much. We'll try it. I'd rather just remove it. We'll try removing it. See if we could always put it back in. Honestly, don't care for the white lettering. And it's not very bright, so I don't think cleaning it's going to help. Well, that's what it looks like when it's cleaned up. I found that it had dirt in between both panels. So, doesn't come out in one piece. It's pretty brittle. But let's see if there's a difference in the display. I'll have to squint to see it. Should be. Well, that's not bad. You can see it now. tape tuner. It's not bad at all. It's better than it was. Obviously, it's a tube, so like this could have been in a, it could have been in a place that sat. It was running 24/7, so the belts came out for the tape deck. But I can tell you that this unit must be pretty old, because these things are like licorice, basically. You can pull them apart. It's pretty bad. So that'll have to wait for another video. But we got that a little bit brighter. You can actually see it now. It's clean. CD player works. Got a couple of knobs laying around here. Let's try this one. Hey, look at that. It was made for it. Sweet. Okay, well, hopefully someone can use the repair video for the CD player. It's just a bunch of belts. Three belts, actually. We'll have to put the ground strap back on and slap her back together for now. But I hope this helps somebody with this model number. Later. Yeah, that's a nice upgrade from the Philips that I had. I got that off of Steve. So, let's see here. Tuner. It's got a much deeper sound to it. This is another issue that I still got to work out. Some dust has got in the digital volume. I have a pot to replace it, but for now, I'll have to do. Elastic bands for from onions. Put the 5 discs in there. Oh yeah, one more. Smith. Let's see if it works. Doing something. I hear it seeking. Sweet. So I'll just take all those belts in and see if I can get the tape that's going.